crocos are can grow like very huge. They're in the beet family. So I replanted that out again after storing the root all winter, and I can collect that seed now.
Now with the carrots and these ones, do you have to take them in and bring them back out?
That's this part of the garden. I'm not sure if we can get over to the other part or not. But some of these things are, this is seed that I was saving, and I've actually already taken some of this. This black scabiosa, which is really just gorgeous, beautiful flowers. I really like these a lot. Two varieties of sunflowers. The first one was a some of these are so diseased, the leaves are given out, but all you can see is the massive tomatoes. So these are pretty cool for a pot. They don't get any bigger. They're three miniature tomatoes. These are, right now, I'm going to get some newspaper and I'm going to wrap it around the base to come up to about here. And I'll leave it on for a couple weeks, and it'll blanch the stalks, and then it's usable as a vegetable. So it'll be a little bit like celery, but it doesn't taste like celery.
It looks like artichoke plants, but yeah, I don't see any artichokes.
No, yeah, this is cardoon. Huh. Yeah, beautiful plants, aren't they? Actually, when I was up in Ancaster a couple years ago, the city of Ancaster, I guess it's the city of Hamilton now, had these in their municipal planters, which I thought was really cool. It's a portion of the stalk, so you're eating about this foot right in here. Uh-huh. Yeah.
Do you find you have to protect ground cherries over the winter with anything, or just leave them in the sun?
They don't survive.
Oh, they don't
survive. No, they don't. No, it's an animal. Yeah. More hot peppers. These are the Naja fallopias, which haven't started to bean stick. Did you know that? That's a game we like to play, Molly and I. We stick the bean leaves on each other's back and then run away. But this is a bean called Blue Ribbon. It's very hard to find the seed for. It's popular in Tennessee. I had a lot of people buying it from Tennessee because they couldn't get it from the regular supplier. And there's another one here that will look similar to you, but it's a bit finer bean called Baba Salvanga, which is another really beautiful bean. They look similar, but the Blue Ribbon will tend to be a lot fatter and shorter. I'm just growing in these bins to see if anything will actually come of it. These seeds are ones that I'm saving because I got the seed from the Heritage Seed Library in England. There are two varieties here. I got five seeds from England.
Wow.
So this is what I'm depending on getting, so I can try these bean seeds. The one variety, only two came up out of five, so I'm depending on two seeds. In through here, there's all variety of different peppers, hot peppers. There's some cool stuff back here. This is the one of my favorite marigolds too. This is the pinwheel marigold.
Oh,
this is an absolutely gorgeous little marigold. I've got some scarlet runner beans. There's some exceedingly hot peppers in here. This one actually is Kevin, the chef at the Inn on the 20, is a good friend, and he brought the seeds for this one back from Italy when he was there. So this is a pepper from Florence, and it's got a lovely flavor. It's really hot though. We've got some of the Naja Holokia peppers in here. That's supposed to be one of the world's hottest. I've got some cute little eggplants. This is called Bambino. This is what we've got. The beets have done very well, in fact, to the point I've started to pull them. So this variety is Detroit Dark Red. This is the area I soaked the seed the night before. This area I did not. The difference has been remarkable. Those are squash bugs, which is a bonus, yeah. Mm-hmm. Squash bugs are bad.
Oh,
yeah. And I got this is Alastinato kale. This is an Italian green called pure cicata. So this is considered a non-heading broccoli. You can see it has a head, but the head's reasonably insignificant.